there's a brand new feature that's been added to Lightroom and Camera Raw, which is the very first step that you should do if you want to get the most out of your photo. And that's selecting the profile. Now we have these new adaptive profiles. Check them out. So this really important feature is skipped by a lot of people because many people just don't even realize it's there or don't realize how important it is. The very first thing you should be doing when you're making adjustments to a photo is choosing the profile. A profile is the way the raw image is interpreted before any adjustments are applied to it, and it works independently of the adjustments and the adjustment sliders inside of Lightroom or Camera Raw. We're going to be looking at Camera Raw in just a moment. But by default, it uses the Adobe Color Profile. Now here's a photo. Let me just hit reset to make sure no adjustments have been applied to it. So we're going to choose the Develop module, and then we're going to choose the four little boxes here, and this will take us into Profiles. So as you scroll down here, you'll see different profiles, and some RAW files will give you the camera profiles, which would be the settings you would see on your camera. Canon, Nikon, all the different manufacturers have their own profiles. In this case, I'm shooting on a DJI drone, and it's using the built-in profile from DJI. But we can also scroll up, and we can see here are the Adobe profiles. So we'll see we've got the Adobe settings here. By default, it usually uses Adobe Color. You'll also see some of these similar ones from your camera manufacturer, say it's Canon or Nikon. You'll see things like color, landscape, portrait, or whatever profiles are available on those cameras. Now we can choose the ones from the cameras or the ones from Adobe. So let's have a look for a moment on the Adobe ones. So we're looking at these profiles. So what it's doing is it's doing a default conversion without analyzing the photo. Now, these are a great way to start because say, for example, I start with Adobe Color. You know, I see it's got a nice low contrast kind of a start, so I can choose Close. Notice none of the adjustments have been moved, and now I can fine tune them by adjusting these sliders. But let's look at what's new. So if we go back in here, and this time we're going to scroll down to Adaptive Presets. So we're going to scroll down, we're going to see Adaptive. Right now, the only one we're going to see is Monochrome. There is a color one, but that's in Camera Raw only. We'll go to that in just a moment. But let me scroll up and show you. So say I do an Adobe Monochrome. So this is going to do a profile, which is going to convert it to black and white. So if we go down to the Adaptive, so it uses AI to analyze the photo, and then it applies a custom profile. So if we have a look now, as I roll over there, look at the better quality from the Adaptive Monochrome. I'm going to roll away. Back on. Let's look at some of the areas. Some of the detail here, some of the detail in the water, maybe the sky, the rocks. Notice as I go over that adaptive, it creates a better profile based on that photo. Let me choose a different photo. So say we grab this photo here. And what we're going to do is let me just go up and I'm going to choose the Adobe Monochrome, since this is the default one. And then we're going to go down to the adaptive one. And notice as I roll over, see how much the contrast is reduced and much more detail is shown. It's darkening down. It's recovering some of the details and the highlights and shadows. And once again, this is just the starting place to begin the image. From there, we can make other adjustments. All right, let's go back to the library. And this time, I'm going to show you how to get this into Photoshop to do the same thing inside of Camera Raw. But Camera Raw also has the color profile. My last tutorial was on reflection removal, and some people struggled to get those photos from Lightroom into Camera Raw. So whether you're doing from that tutorial or from here, follow these steps. So you're just going to right click, and then you're going to choose to edit. And so if we bring this into Photoshop, it's just going to create a PSD or a TIFF depending on your setting. So what we want to do is go down to open as a smart object in Photoshop, and this will keep it as a RAW file. Now it's going to launch Photoshop, and you'll see there's our smart object. If we double click, now it's going to open in Camera Raw. All right, so here we are. Let's have a look at the profiles. So we can see right now we're using the Adobe Color Profile. Now we can see there's the monochrome. There's all the other profiles are available there. So let's roll down, and we're going to go to Adaptive. This time you'll see that we have the monochrome, but we also have a color. Notice that those are beta profiles. So let's roll over the profile. And look at the difference. There's Adobe Color. There's the Adaptive. Before, after. Look how much more detail showing in the rocks, in the water, the sky, before, after. So we're going to apply this profile, and then you're just going to choose the back button. Notice when we go to the back button, none of our adjustments have been made. We're just starting with the profile. So we still have the ability to make all of these adjustments, but this is just going to give us a much better starting place, and it's going to help us achieve better images. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Drop a comment underneath and let me know if you learned anything new. And if you're new here to the cafe, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.